Denver Broncos and the Los Angeles Chargers.
Michael Badgley to kick off for the Chargers.
Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season. Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
To the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Throwing now is Locke. Complete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn into a shootout. The offense has to keep pace.
And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as they'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game. Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. Here comes Graham on the return. Covered an even 40-yard punt, 7 though on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over.
32-yard line.
Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, 1st and 10. At about the 32. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
He's tackled.
You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Now they try the right side here.
The super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front. When the time heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. This is going to be thinking out. That's not always your things to come. Very first pass of the afternoon.
And where do you go from here? Because when you start that way, do you allow that to seep into you and stay with you the rest of the game? Or do you find a way out of it? We're going to find out.
After the turnover, here's Locke. They find Lindsey here. No gain there on the first down play.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down the distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. From the gun, it's Locke. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders fly to the football to win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Good go.
Throwing is Locke on 3rd down. Looking for Cook, but this pass is intercepted.
He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
The Charger drive about to get going. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they do.
They take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
At the 36-yard line.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. It's Lindsay. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Of course, he was solid last week. AFC Offensive Player of the Week award. Two touchdowns in that game.
Yeah, he's playing at a level right now where he's just breaking down defenses. Makes me remember when I was playing and my defensive back coach told me, listen, if you give up a touchdown pass, that's on me. I didn't coach you well enough. If you give up a second one, that's on you. And if there's a third one, I'm getting someone else in the game.
A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
First down, Denver.
Here's Lindsay. And they get him down right about the 20.
Philip Lindsay.
Joey Bosa in on the stop. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight.
A gain of two. Brings up
faking the give to Lindsay. Here's Locke. Sliding out of the pocket. And he just chopped that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Pretty wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. So a failure to connect on second down. That leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Shotgun snap to Lock. The LA defense up the snuff and coverage there. Pushes this to fourth down.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? Session on every t-shirt has been printed in football. It says finish on it, because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
The Charger drive about to get going. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, trying to get things settled down a little bit.
At the 18-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. A shotgun snap for Herbert.
This offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate. It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first two possessions, and now it's looking like none on this one either.
Punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And he'll be set up with great field position as this is going to be touchdown right at the 40-yard line. On first and 10, here's Locke. Oh, the man is Kirk complete. Not much there, only a yard.
When you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Lock on the give, it's Lindsay. And he is out of bounds, but Bob McFerrin is inside the 40. 11 yards there, first down. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
Get about four as he's brought down at the 24.
The tackle made at the 24-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
From the 24. Lock. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown.
To O.J. Howard.
O.J. Howard. Denver. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
The extra
he's
point
got
is
it,
good.
And now it's a 10-0 lead here in the opening quarter.
10. Chargers, nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. Decision to bring it out. Ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. He's going to walk for a deep left side here. It's caught inside the 25. Barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Justin Herbert looking to pass. This is going to be intercepted. Michigan manager. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 20-yard line.
They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. Up to about the 35.
Brought down at the
15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. On first down, right back to Lindsey. Step up right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
The 35-yard line.
And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes.
Okay, you know what? Bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
The defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here.
You have to look out for the more pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
A 28-yard
that gain on third down, good for 28. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 39-yard line. A run with Lindsey out of the gun. And he'll get four here down to the 35-yard line.
Lindsey on the carry.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish an inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. Let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job standing in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the gun on third down, flush to his right. The Charger D making things difficult, and it's fourth down. What a difference a week makes. Last week, he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week, he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense has spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try to chip away this timing.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field. Certainly not what they wanted.
That is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot. Great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
They turned the ball over last time. Let's see if they can avoid doing it here. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Brought down at the 23-yard line.
Out of the gun, Herbert. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Herbert with a connection to Allen for a Charger first down. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Finds a man on the crossing route. His second catch, this one not quite as dynamic as his first, and it's second down.
Brings up second and four at the 44-yard line.
Second and long after the hold. From the gun, Herbert. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty. Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. Herbert off the play action. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. First target, first catch, and a first down. That's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Instead, second down.
They've had multiple opportunities on offense and still haven't scored any points. Felt like they wanted to loosen things up, throw it downfield, and see if maybe they could get a big play and a quick strike.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside game. And he'll be down close to the first down marker as he gets this to the Broncos 36. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now it's Herbert. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Get two here, stopped at the 30.
To number 24.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Now this one is right out of the backfield. This is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos 17-yard line.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover. The angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back.
And his passes are intercepted for a 13 today. Mistakes continuing to pile up, and it looked like they were going to be able to eat into that deficit. Instead, now the deficit is even larger.
Yeah, they were on a march with a chance to get back within a score, but now that deficit continues to grow.
So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, and now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
Now the extra point.
Nothing.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. takes this about 5 yards deep.
Stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And his kick here is good. And that one is scored out. It's 23-0. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get three before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. We haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of the half. They'll be real excited to have those opponents.
The Chargers take over first and 10.
And the Charger drive about to get going. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. Because it'll be better with the front end in this position.
So last time, it didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly first what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Operating from the gun. Herbert. Caught it here, and that's complete. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. Bombs away right there. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Chargers going to get the football first here in the second half, and they trail as we get back underway. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
We're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable with the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score.
5 yard line.
Second down, here's Herbert. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Herbert able to show his wheels as he gets the first.
Looks to me, Parker, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception. Really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Hargrave.
And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
They'll try the air now with Herbert. Incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
The passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo. And
the first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing. They're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
34 yards there, and a first down.
First down, Broncos.
Now it's Lindsey. Leaves him with two to go on second down. Well, you certainly
have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oftentimes when you're losing the game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
They'll try and run for it with Lindsey. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
Fourth down.
So they'll turn to the kicker again. He's been a busy man thus far. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick is good. And that lead will move from 21 to 23. So making four out of four now in the field goal department, and he's able to extend their lead.
When drives have bogged down, he's been automatic out there. So nice to have a kicker you can count on to put points on the board.
Probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
16-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that at everyone.
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Let's go on attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10.
Block working out of the gun.
the 45. 23 yards on the play.
It's a gain of 1 play,
and they're already just shy of midfield.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. Well, I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
On second and 11 now. Flushed out right. He'll try and run it. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Down Denver.
Shotgun snap and a give to Lindsey. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
They'll go again with Lindsey. This is first and goal. They'll run with Lindsey. And he'll be stacked up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense, because they're facing one of the top 5 offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've got an answer for it.
It is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown.
Christian
Kirk.
Touchdown
number 8 on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front. And the lead opens up now to 22 points.
Broncos 33. Chargers 11.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Charger drive about to get going. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
And now he's going to use his legs.
Herbert,
give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here's Herbert now on second down. And that's complete. And it takes us into a 30-yard line before being corralled. On first down, Justin Herbert over the middle, and it's caught. Keenan Allen. Across midfield inside the 45 yards. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First and 10 at the 43.
On first down now. Getting it over to Mitch Williams. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. 23 yards, the final tally.
First and 10 at the 20-yard line.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside hit. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13.
Brought down at the
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Brings up second and 3.
From
the shotgun now. Here's an inside game. And he takes it on for the Charger touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. From the gun. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
Score, Broncos 33, Chargers 17.
Following the touchdown, Badgley out there to kick it away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Broncos take over. First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away.
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away.
A gain of
first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Down, nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. And they come up on second down. Another run by Lindsey. He's got first down and inside the midfield.
That the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side of this one.
And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game. Second and 10, here's Herbert once more. He's going to walk through a deep left side. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first. From the shotgun now, here's an inside hitter. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
By number 24.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Operating from the gun. Herbert will dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
On first and 10, Herbert. That's caught inside the 20. And give him 32 on the play.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
That throw into the arms of Allen. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Complete to Keenan Allen.
To the air again. To his running back, complete. And we are inside of
2 minutes left in this lopsided affair.
So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Or the ball carrier.
They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
No gain on the play.
Extra bulk up front for second and inches. Three tight ends.
They'll try to run this one in. And this time he is in. A great effort there with his third touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. Here's Herbert and the Chargers. And they'll indeed take a knee. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. A lot going to throw it here. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw it is Locke. He's got it. Second back at the 42. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away.
Jakeem Grant on the return. The Chargers take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I've never played for a guy who's rebounded huge. And someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He was willing to hand him. Who cares? Let's get out of here. We'll do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to
put this one behind them.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
This taken in by Jakeem Grant. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Third, second down completion got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3. Herbert back to the air. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Sets up a 1st and goal. Herbert throwing again. Now the incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
From the contact. Brings up 2nd and goal.
They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. Again, Herbert.
Williams, incomplete, brings up 3rd and goal.
The ball mere inches from the white line on 3rd and goal.
One last throw here for Herbert. That's intercepted at the goal line.
Can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Denver, their winning ways continue as they get it up to 7-0. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again.